In order to train the parameters of logistic regression, we need to define a cost function. So just a brief recap of what we saw in the previous video. We calculate the weighted sum of this input and we add to it bias and we get a value which we will call Z. And this Z, in particular ZI, so here this superscript I denotes ith training example, is this term W transpose XI, which denotes ith training example plus bias. So here it will denote this, and this will be the prediction for ith example. And here ZI is given as 1 over 1 plus e to the power minus z. And we are given a training set of n training examples from 1 to m. And we want that the prediction for ith training set is very close to the actual level value of y. So we will now define the loss function or error function. This loss or error function is a measure of how well we are doing on a single training example. And here you see single training example and not the entire training set. For that, we will separately see cost function. So first, let's understand loss function. So what can be a good loss function? One loss function you can think is that you find the square difference. So this is for one given example. So if you are talking about, let's say, ith value, then this will be I. Everything you can replace by superscript I. So for ith training example, we see what was the actual level data and what was the predicted value. We find the difference of that. We square it and we do half of that. But this is not used in logistic regression, although it's a good loss function. So it's not used in logistic regression because when you come to learn the parameters, you find that the optimization problem, which we will talk about later, becomes a non-convex. So we end up with the optimization problem with multiple optima. So, and gradient descent may settle on one of the local minima. For example, let's say here. And it may not discover the global optimum. So that's why we will not be using this loss function in logistic regression. So in logistic regression, what loss function we will use? We will use and here we are talking about single training example, so I will omit this superscript negative of y, the actual level, log y predicted plus 1 minus y log 1 minus predicted y. And we always want the loss function to be as small as possible. So this entire quantity should be as small as possible. So let's say the actual level is y. Actual level should be y. So what we will want? We will want that predicted value should also be close to 1. And this y is calculated using this sigmoid function. And we have seen that this sigmoid function always takes values between 0 and 1. So it can never cross 1 and it can never be less than 0. And in the mid, it's 0.5. So it can never cross 1. In fact, it's very difficult also to get exactly 1. It's not possible. It tends towards 1, but it's always slightly less. So our aim will be that in such case, for example, y equal to 1 denotes the images of cats, then in that case, we will want that this predicted value should be close to 1. So let's see how this cost function, how this loss function works there. So if y is 1, what will happen? This becomes 1 minus 1, which is 0. So this term goes away and we will be left with loss equal to minus y log y predicted. So when y becomes 1, this is the scenario. So let's see the graph of this. So we know that log y will be this value at 1. Log of 1 is 0. Log of less than 1 quantity is negative. And at close to 0, it's close to negative infinity. So this is the plot for log y. We are taking minus of that. So reverse it. So it will become like this. And this is 1. So you see here, it's close to infinity. This loss function is on y-axis, which is minus log y. This red line is the actual loss function. And close to 0, it's very high, very, very high, close to infinity. And it decreases. And at 1, it's exactly 0. It cannot be more than 1 due to this sigmoid function. So it will try to reach as close to 1 as possible, this predicted value of y, in order to minimize the loss. So you see, this works well. So if actual level is 1, this loss function forces it to make y predicted also close to 1 in order to minimize the loss. Now let's see the other scenario. When y equal to 0, then the first term goes away. 0 multiplied by anything is 0. And this is 0, so this is 1 minus 0. So we are left with minus 1 minus y is 0. So we will delete that. So it becomes minus log of 1 minus y predicted. And here also this y is not required, it's 1. So this was log y, which was the loss function. Now let's plot for this. So let's first plot 1 minus log y. So when y hat becomes 0, this will be 0. So at 0, it's 0. At 1, it's close to negative infinity. It's something like that. This log 1 minus y. But we are taking negative of this. So this will become like this. And it will continue in this direction. We will not consider that because we are limiting to 0 and 1. So this is the loss function. L when actual level is 0. This was the loss when L was 1. Actual level was 1. So you see, close to 1, it's very large value, close to infinity. At 0, it's exactly 0. So this predicted value of y will try its best to reach towards 0 in order to minimize the loss function. So you see, this loss function works for both the scenarios. In both cases, this loss function enforces the model to the logistic regression to makes its predicted value close to the actual level value. Now let's look at the cost function. So cost function is how well, an estimate of how well we are doing on the entire training set and not the single training example, which was the case with loss function. And loss function applies to single training example, but cost function is a cost of your parameters, and our parameters are W and B. So we will denote the loss function by this capital letter J, and it will be a function of our parameters. So the job of cost function is to train these parameters in such a way that the cost function is minimum. So after one epoch, you can think them, all the parameters are updated, and again the cost function is calculated, and again one pass through the training example, and again these are updated until the cost function is minimized. So we will define it as sum of all the training examples. So what we will do, we will just add the loss function and I is from 1 to m. M denotes the number of training examples. So for each training example, we will compare this and we will add and take the average. This will be our cost function. So what was this loss function? We can expand it. It was y I log y predicted I plus 1 minus y log of 1 minus y predicted I. So this will be our cost function, and our job will be to find parameters w and v which will minimize the cost function j. So we saw how to define loss function and cost function for logistic regression. In a way, this logistic regression can be thought of as a mini neural network and not a deep neural network. So we will see more about neural networks in future lessons.